Hello, namaste, good morning to all online respected viewers. Long live their majesties, long live our leaders, and long live our friendship. Welcome to this online Ayurveda and Yoga sessions. Embassy of India, Thimphu, ICCR's Nehru Wangchuk Cultural Center, yoga teacher, MKVSSN Murthy here. My true prayers to the Almighty to see all the best things to their majesties in the whole Bhutan. Before recitation, coming to the simple protocols for this COVID situations, even though if you are getting vaccinations, don't forget to follow the safe physical distancing. Almost try to avoid crowdings, or if you want to go inside the crowds, please try to cover your total facial organs through available sources or spectacles or ear caps or masks and everything. Most important thing is, when you are coming back to the home, try to properly wash them or properly throw them into the dustbins. Don't throw it on the roads. And next one is, do not touch any kind of surfaces when you are in the crowds. And if you prefer your hand wash through soap water, that is the best. Second option is hand lotions. Carry your hand lotions for your quick method of cleaning for the hands. Next one is, do not count currency or don't count papers by touching your tongue. And hand hygiene and respiratory hygiene, very important, especially respiratory hygiene. You can use Anutaila or Shatbindu Taila, or you can use plain cow ghee also. Early in the morning, one drop into the nostrils. In the evening also, you can use these practices, especially for the people who are having this snoring trouble. So for them also, this application will be very useful. Next one is a throat gargling technique. You can use plain salt water, or you can use Estimadu powder, or you can use Tripala powder, acceptable hot water, and mix with these two, and please use this for throat cleaning. So that's also very important technique. Next one is steam inhalation is very, very important, because it can be only one big source to kill the viral cells, which will be hidden inside the paranasal and parasinus cavities inside the nostrils. The drinking of the hot water really create that kind of effect to the virus, but steam inhalation, hot air, will create that balance. So next one is vitamin A and vitamin D and zinc based diets, which will be available in local green leafy vegetables and organic items and milk products and mushrooms. So according to your allergy concerns, you can use these practices also. So next one is physical exercises, morning half an hour to 45 minutes and evening also half an hour to 45 minutes. Please try to go for good physical exercises. Physical exercise, not like it is not only good for the sake of the flexibility or fitness or agility, but it is directly giving effect to the lungs. It will train the lungs. Once lungs will be very fit and safe, then no issues of the any other viral infections or bacterial infections, plus the recovery rate will be very easy and very quick. So next one is home remedies, home Ayurvedic remedies, what we generally call as turmeric and honey, local honey and ilachi and cinnamon and cumin and coriander, garlic, ajwain seeds and hing. Ajwain powder also you can use in your regular kitchen items. And hing, asafoetida, also very important to create wind balance inside. Next one is pepper, rock salt, cordyceps, shilajit. All these are simple kitchen ingredients. So according to your timings, according to your diet prescriptions, you can use these simple things also in your diet to create good balance for the blood composition, as well as health and immunity, metabolic activity, as well as it's good for the relieving constipations also. Especially Chyawanprash and two important health tonics called golden milk, as well as kadha chai preparations, also very good to create immunity balance. Next one is home remedies, what we generally call pumpkin seeds and red pepper and dark chocolate. According to your diabetes concern, dark chocolates are also good to create good mood. Basically, dark chocolates are mood creators. Next one is mushrooms and broccoli, berries and wheatgrass powder and plain wheatgrass and peanuts, very simple and effective protein source called peanuts and groundnuts, and spinach and some of the local leafy vegetables. So in your food, try to see how can you compose your good diet with adding all these items. Okay, coming to the recitation, this recitation actually from the Hatha Yoga Pradipika. This is also saying about the very important practices called Mayurasana, peahen poster or peacock poster. Today I will go to demonstrate that two posters. It is saying that harati sakala roganasu gulmodaradhi nabhibhavati cha dosha nasanam sri mayuram bahuka dasana buktam basma kuryadaseisham janayati jataragni jarayet kala kutam. So briefly it is saying that this poster will be very good for the people who are having this abdominal issues, especially PCOD issues or constipation or PCOS issues or diabetes or liver sluggishness of the liver or any kind of intestinal disorders which will be in the initial stages. If people will really follow this kind of posters which will directly give the effect on the abdomen for them, it is very easy to overcome that kind of the disorders which is directly begins from your abdominal region and lower abdominal region. But here contraindications are, so if you have high blood pressure you can do, but do it very slow. If you have any other issues or renal issues or any other complication related lungs, you can do, but do it very slow or take advice. So here anyone can do the practices according to their limits and according to their convenience, but it is always good to associate with your yoga teacher who are having the knowledge of Ayurveda and overall health. But in this week, as we know that we are seeing PCOD and PCOS issues, so we have many causes for this same PCOD and PCOS issues. In Ayurveda it is saying that anarthavam or artava dosham or sukra dhatu or rajo dhatu vikari. So it is basically because of genes and heredity and insulin interferences, insulin over interferences and obesity and inactiveness and hormonal imbalances because of stress. So these are four or five are important causes. Characteristics are sudden weight gaining and pimples are somewhat rashes on the skin and brown patches and blemishes and unwanted hair. And the next one is weakness and hair falling and irregular or over menstruation. If you once notice this kind of situations and try to immediately avoid high fat diet in your food, as well as avoid deep fries and avoid overeating and over resting. So what we call a passive life. Alcohol and smoking also killer factors. Please avoid them for a few months or till you are recovered. And next one is avoid self-medication. After seeing Google differences or after seeing online differences, do not use any medicines. But for knowledge, you can see the Google or you can watch any, you can see any book. But while coming to the uses for your own body, it is always better to take advice from the physician. If he prescribed for further medical investigations, do not neglect that also. Next one is junk timings and junk foods. And important thing is, steroids and drugs. If you already been using this kind of steroids and drug uses, please immediately stop or take advice from your physician. So the last important bad habits are negligence and laziness. So these are all also these two will create still more damage to the body if we have this kind of two agents. Please remember all these items. So coming to Ayurvedic point of view, so in the Ayurveda point of view, we have especially for this kind of PCOD and PCOS, we have a small Ayurvedic drugs. Those are not really chemical, those are only herbal based medicines only, called Raja Pravardhani Vati. Next one is Satavari. Next one is Tripala Churna, Tripala powder or Tripala capsule form. It will somewhat lower the follicles inflammation. This is very important technique, Tripala. Next one is Naga Kesara Churna. It's a Indian rose chestnut powder form or bark powder, also available through online. So but take doctor's advice how to use these practices. Pushyanuraga Churnam, this is also a kind of powder. And next one is Kanchanala Gugulu. You can make it as a powder or boiled water, and you can use Ashoka, Lodhara, Ashodabasma. These are very simple herbal based medicines. These are not really metals. But today's Ayurvedic home remedies, we have very few Ayurvedic remedies called. When you have this kind of issues, do not neglect the situation. Please immediately use at least these kind of four practices. One is plain onion or spring onion. So take 25 grams to 50 grams. So try to use 300 ml of water to boil this solution. So wait till this total solution will come to the 150 ml decoction form. Basically, I'm telling about decoction form. Use honey or jaggery, and every day morning 20 ml to 30 ml, evening 20 ml to 30 ml. Try to use this solution. This is very important practices. But the women who are at the stage of monthly sickness, don't use this solution for the 3-4 days. Remaining people easily can use, but this usage will give result in just 20 to 25 days. But please avoid the that exact menstrual cycle period, 3 to 4 days. So next one is Navasara or Navakshara. It's a powder form. It's a basically NH4Cl. Chemical name is NH4Cl. It's a kind of salt, ammonium chloride. It's a ammonia chloride. Take that stone form of that chemical and powder it. So take 50 grams to 100 grams and first boil that total solution. So this is not decoction. After boil and throw that total water out, and that remaining residue will be like a powder form. So use capsules and fill in that capsules morning one, evening one, or evening only once. So you have to follow this practice for at least 1 month timing. This is also not really medicine, this is only salt. But while using this kind of practices, one should drink more water also in a day, like hot water. Especially I'm talking about hot water. This is also very simple solution to create a very good balance, especially for the women regarding PCOD or PCOS or any other cysts inside. So next one is residue of sesame seeds after oiling, taking out. Then we had that defatted pulp. That is also very important. That's actually abundant, having iron content, especially in your daily diets, morning or evening, or at least morning. You can choose this one as a food item. So as a curry preparation, or you can use in your regular home diets also after boiling this one. Very simple and effective remedy to create iron balance inside. So next one is fennel seeds decoction. Fennel seeds boil, you can use 30 grams of fennel seed powder and use 250 ml of water and mix it properly and wait till this decoction form will come to 100 ml. Then use this decoction form morning once or evening once, or only morning once with the empty stomach. So these are all simple home Ayurvedic home kitchen remedies. These are all food practices. So if you have any doubt regarding this usage, please try to take advice from the people who have had these experiences regarding this kind of home remedies. Or you can put your comment also under this video if you have doubts about the usage of these practices. Alright, when we will meet on Monday at the same time, same topic, means we will see some other disorder from next Monday. We will see still more good applications in Ayurveda as well as kitchen home remedies also. Let's join to the yoga class now. I will demonstrate the peacock posture and swan posture and related one or two postures also. Alright. So from the beginning, I'm requesting my video technician to come on my right side or left side to cover the total class, so that it is very easy to the people who are watching this video, especially the posters and the sun salutations also. Okay, now coming to sun salutations, take a long deep inhalations and exhalations. So the total yoga practices, whether it will be probes or whether it will be no probes, but here please remember, the way how it will active the body is important. The way how it will create the hormonal imbalances and harmony also very important. But please remember, our activeness will bring lots of health changes, positive changes in the health. Then coming to sun salutations, take a long deep inhalation, exhalation. Now lift your both the arms up above to the head, called Pranamasana Kailash Mudra, and the same mudra will come towards your chest, called Anahata Pranamasana. Here we have mantra chanting, sloka and bijakshara according to your traditional belief, you can use the mantra chanting or you can use only physical practices. And long, slow, deep inhalation, exhalation. All right, practicing our sloka. Om Hiranmayena Patrena Satyasyapi Hitam Mukham Tattvam Pushan Apavrunu Satya Dharmaya Drushtaye Om Hram Hrim Hrum Hraim Haum Raha Mitra Ravi Surya Bhanu Kagapushna Hiranya Garbhamaricha Aditya Savitra Arka Bhaskaraya Namaha. And stretch your arms forward for Hasta Uttanasana. From here, once completely pull up. And according to your balance, keep a back bend called Ardha Chandrasana or Ardha Chakrasana. Then body straight, again pull up. And when you have issues at the lower back or neck or mid back or blood fluctuation issues or ear problems or head issues or heart problems, avoid forward bends or according to your convenience, choose proper way of doing. This is what we call Padahastasana or forward bend, standing forward bend. And right leg is your back leg called Aswasanchalanasana, horse riding posture. Push your body forward, lift your chin and stay for a while here. And back leg straight on the toes and back leg knee up. Join your forward leg to back leg called Dandasana or Santulanasana. Then very slowly towards the floor according to your convenience, just try to stick the body and chest and two palms, forehead or chin and knees and toes. Ashtanga Namaskarasana or Sastanga Namaskarasana. Like a sea wave, push the body forward and lift the body up. Lifted head cobra posture or bhujangasana, once completely give a stretch and back leg straight on the toes and push your body inside called parvatasana or mountain triangular posture. And right leg is your forward leg again, push your body down as well as forward, also lift your chin, stay for a while here called Aswasanchalanasana, horse riding posture. Alright, back leg straight on the toes and knee up. Join your back leg to forward leg called Padahastasana. And right, lift your arms and body at a time but very slowly lift them up called Hasta Uttanasana. Again, once completely pull yourself up and slightly put a back bend Ardha Chandrasana or Ardha Chakrasana. Again, body straight, Pranamasana about to the head. Then very slowly bring your pranamasana down at your chest level called Anahata Pranamasana. And soon after that, lift your arms with inhalation. Then along with exhalation, wide your hands. Then very slowly bring them down. Alright, soon after this practices, give a small break for your healthy breath by keeping gap in between your legs and lock your hands back. And a long, slow, deep inhalation and exhalation. Alright, so today's postures will be our Mayurasana and Lotus Peacock posture also. But according to your convenience, you can just make a trial. Don't look for the rights or wrongs, or don't look for the postural performances, and do not compare with others with what you are doing. It's a kind of trial making only. Alright, so if you have knee issues, better to choose knee caps, or if you have severity in the knee issues, avoid the next exercises. Alright, take just long deep inhalations and exhalations. Alright, so before I'm adding this Mayurasana in the practices, I would like to go for two pre-positions. These three pre-positions will be useful as a post-positions also. One is Ashwini Mudrasana and second one is Vajrasana, okay? So basically it will relieve the strain from the above back and neck level. After doing your this Mayurasana, one can easily experience this kind of relaxation through these two postures. So one is, first thing is Seshankasana. So you can choose like a closed legs, or you can give a small gap also in between the legs. But once completely stretch your arms forward and put your head on the floor and stay here. One, 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8 and 9 then very slowly keep your both the hands back and lift your chin then very slowly keep them up then long slow deep inhalations and exhalations and next one is Ashwini Mudrasana again use your two hands then after that close your two fist and put it on one on second fist so here lift your buttocks and lift your waist up push your body forward keep your chin or forehead on the above fist and from here slightly hang your body towards the floor so this is also very relaxing posture for the people who are having this neck issues especially in this posture one should perform the Moolabandha also as well as Ashwini Mudra means it's a kind of locking at the anal region but we are not doing any kind of bandhas and mudras we are using simple posture all right and then very slowly relax your hands and slowly get back then from there again slowly keep your hands drag back lift your chin and relaxation okay let's coming to the two postures one is peacock open legs and after that same peacock with the crossed legs or lotus posture so right so check your convenience check your dress check your mat and check your breath so initially if you want to do these postures especially for the beginners you can use one or two pillows also just next to your head or under your head so somewhat it will protect you when you will fall down okay and now try to check your arm fitness also so first try to widen your legs in the Vajrasana and try to put your left hand inside by turning your fingers towards your perineal region then after that keep turning your alternate hand also by turning them inside so observe your like hand convenience and hand fitness if you have already have any issues in the hand level or hand bones or fingers or wrist better to avoid or take support of a good props okay now here lift your waist up and try to put your head on the floor but carefully down don't drop the head suddenly but you can slightly bring your head down and after that right leg stretch back and left leg stretch back adjust your both the elbows inside then here I'm doing swan posture hamsasana and on the elbows base try to push your body and few seconds stay now lift your chin and don't lift your toes from the beginning so it is a pre position of the actually pick up posture 1 2 3 4 and 5 then same thing first bring your knees down and head down then slowly drag your right knee inside left knee inside and leave your both the hands then as it easily you can rest your spine down and relax for a while for the same relaxation again I'm using second exercise called Ashwini Mudrasana again this is also relieve the actually strain from the previous posture or still if you want take more relaxation shavasana also good exercise just lying on the back as a corpse okay now taking our next exercise called peacock posture with total leg lift also so the total body should be balanced on the two hand support all right now same thing here first Vajrasana sit on the knees widen your knee structures then after that both the hands must come together by turning your fingers towards your toes so during the posture also if you feel like any inconvenience you can adjust your hands so be very convenient and confident before doing the posture and during the posture and after posture all right adjust your legs right this time also I'm now lifting my body up and put my head on the floor and both the legs back then here also lift your head then very slowly push your body forward try to lift your both the legs up so this may be an advanced posture but when you have good commitment and knowledge on the doing anyone can perform in just 21 days 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8 and 9 then slowly come back
and resting. Then very slowly keep your both the legs together. Then wide your both the hands. Then very slowly rest as it is lead towards the floor. And few seconds rest. Using our second posture for relaxation, keep your both the fists together, one fist and second fist, and lift your back and keep rest your head on the fist and stay now. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 and relaxation enough. Come back. Alright, very slowly come straight. But please remember, while doing this exercise, when people will get kind of giddiness or throwing sensation or any sickness, at that point immediately leave the practices. So take at least half an hour gap. Again, if you want restart, you can restart. Okay, long, slow and deep inhalation, exhalation. So the same thing I'm doing, same posture with the lotus. Somewhat this is also an advanced posture, but according to your convenience and fitness, according to your probes health, you can take a chance by making a trial this posture also. Alright, so here, both the hands together, turn your both the palms inside. I'm doing same peacock posture but lotus peacock. And from the beginning, take support of the hands properly. And keep your healthy breath. Do not struggle for the breath while in the posture or before or after postures. Alright, this time again same peacock posture. Then according to your convenience, fold two legs like lotus. Lift your lotus up, lift your head also up. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. And 9, then very slowly open your legs, then put your head down and keep your both the legs together and drag them inside. Then again slowly wide your hands and rest relaxation, you know. Alright, lift your head, then lift your back and put your forehead on the above fist for more relaxation. Alright, then slowly come back. Then again here, keep your both the hands together and keep your body down and drag your hands back. Lift your head, then lift the chin and come straight. But still, as I mentioned before, you can do shavasana also after this kind of advanced postures. But please remember, when you have this commitment to do this kind of exercises, not less than 21 days anyone can perform. But here continuity in the practices is very important. Alright, now coming to pranayama exercises. So it can be covered in front of me now. if you really use these practices with proper breath balance, with proper theory and with proper knowledge, we will not struggle because of yoga postures. Before yoga or during the yoga postures or after yoga postures, we can feel a kind of relaxation. If once we will not feel the relaxation, we have to do more or we have to learn more or we have to practice more with a good knowledge and good theory. So that I'm always requesting that please try to associate with your yoga teacher when it's possible to take good notes regarding yoga postures. Right, long, slow, deep inhalations and exhalations. So after this kind of advanced postures, better to not giving more time for your breakfast. Always advanced postures demands the quick food also. So in between the practices, if you really feel thrust or if you will feel really energy loss, just you can drink a sip of water also, or you can sip a very, very thin varieties juices. But that depends on the quality, how you are doing and what kind of health issues you have and from which teacher you are learning, from which school you are learning. So these are all actually factors. Alright, so choose any convenient, comfortable posture, lotus or half lotus or any other posture. You can sit on the chair also for pranayama. All right, take a long, deep, slow inhalation and exhalation. Right, to keep your spine erect, you can catch your knees with the two hands, or you can put your hands by turning your palms towards the sky, and you can add your index finger to the thumb for your more awareness. Right, coming to actually practices, take a long, slow and deep inhalation and exhalations. And we have pranayam sloka and pranayam mantra. According to your belief system, you can follow this one also. Keep your both the palms together. Om Kesavaya Swaha. Om Madhavaya Swaha. Om Narayanaya Swaha. Om Adya Samadhi Tatpala Siddhyardham Asana Purvakan Pranayamadin Karishye. Om Sandh Sandh Sandhi. And hands down, just long, deep, slow inhalation and exhalation. Right, in other words, this sloka is saying that yoga postures or pranayam or kriyas or cleaning techniques, mudras or bandhas, whatever yoga practices in hatha yoga or raja yoga, the purpose is for to reach self-realization or to reach spiritual upliftment in the form of samadhi or in the form of nirvana. To reach that state, one should be aware of the physical body health and mind health and social health. And if once you will have these three successful segments, then the next level will be matured towards the spiritual upliftment. Okay, now coming to the actually practices. Today also our practices are on the Bhastrika and Kapalabhati. One is sharp exhalation. The second practice is sharp inhalation. So here also I am not giving any fast practices, any tough exercises, any breath holding techniques. Very simple and very effective. First coming to Kapalabhati Sadhan. So take a long deep inhalation exhalation. So Kapalabhati, it's saying that Vastrava Loha Karasya Recha Purav Sasam Bhramav Kapalabhatir Vikyata Kapadosha Visoshini. So whatever phlegm related errors, mucus related errors inside the ribcage or the esophagus or the throat or the facial level or even the head level, that will be totally cut down to the normal. So here Kapalabhati's nickname is Kapadosha Visoshini. So phlegm level disorders will be eradicated. And next one is Bhastrika Pranayam, saying that Vata Pitta Slashma Haram Sariragni Vivardhanam Kundali Bodhakam Kshipram Pavanam Sukadam Hitam Brahma Nadi Mukhe Samasta Kapadyargala Nasanam. So in other words, it is saying that not only phlegm level but wind level errors as well as bile level errors also be totally nullified because of this Bhastrika Pranayam. But not only that, it is also mentioned that for the people who wants to awakening the internal dormant energies, for them also this Bhastrika is very important, especially for the people who wants to do mantra practices or tantric practices or yoga practices, or even it is direct relevance towards the Ayurveda also. But especially, so actually if you don't want to use any of this one, for your general lungs health fitness also, you can use this Bhastrika Pranayam. It's basically called as bellow breathing. It's a sharp inhalation. So once you will use this kind of sudden inhalations, obviously the minute parts in the lungs called alveoli also, it will be open. The totally structure will be glow because of this simple pranayams. Okay, coming to the Kapalabhati. So today also 30 strokes in 3 spells, 10 plus 10 plus 10. Keep the body straight and take a long deep inhalation exhalation. And starting our Kapalabhati sharp exhalation, then starting 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Then we are doing Kapalabhati now in a medium pace.
just take a long deep inhalation exhalation. But the same contraindications when you have ear issues or head issues or throwing issues or any blood pressure issues or heart ailments or any other sickness related to the head or the eyes or the ears or the blood or the towards the heart, please do very carefully and very slow, or still you can avoid till your next instruction will come from your teacher. And next, the second spell I'm doing, then 2, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Just again, long, deep, slow inhalation and exhalation. Without giving much break in between the next spell, from one spell to other spell, starting our next spell, starting 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Again, long breath, long, slow and deep inhalation and exhalation. So when you want, keep your hands on the knees, that's also okay. Or when you want, move your palms at your abdomen level, that's also okay. But anyhow, keep your chest straight, sternum straight, and expand your chest while inhalation, and in totally your back must be erected. Now coming to next one is Bhastrika Pranayam, bellows inhalation, bellows breathing. It's a sharp inhalation, completely opposite side process of Kapalabhati. Then here also contraindications are same. When you have any health issues, immediately don't jump into these practices. Better to choose advice from your yoga teacher and physicians. All right, coming to practices, starting 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Just take a long pause, inhalation and exhalation. Then coming to second spell, starting 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Then again, long, deep inhalation and exhalation. Last spell towards the 30th stroke. Again, starting 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Just take a long, deep inhalation and exhalation. All right, just free your hands. And when once you will totally finish your pranayama exercises, still if you know well about the dharana practices, you can immediately do the dharana exercises by concentrating your mind at your eyebrow center or according to your teacher's guidance. Or when you know about this concentration practices from the trataka format, immediately you can choose that practices also, because immediately after pranayama, concentration levels will be more. So that before your meditation techniques, pranayama is always suggested. And after, once you finish these practices called pranayama, dharana practices or trataka abhyasas, so still please create some more time to give rest to the body and mind through yoga nidra or through power naps. So like depend on the intensity of the practices and strength in the practices, it is also advised to give 15 to 20 minutes time or further more time to take bath, and from there 10 minutes time to take breakfast. In the afternoon before your lunch hour, try to see all the possibilities how to take a power nap or how to do a yoga nidra. It can be performed while sitting on the chairs also. This instruction may be applicable to the office goers or the people who are having busy schedules. In the evening, once you will be totally free from your all activities and affairs, before your dinner time, try to see at least half an hour time to do self yoga exercises, including back bending exercises and including inverted postures and including breathe in and breathe out in the pranayama forms also. Once you decided to eating, please remember, do not blindly depend on the carbohydrates. So try to be aware of that, how your plate is composed with all
all kind of all available source of like good proteins and limited fats and limited carbohydrates and more vegetables and in the form of vitamins and minerals. In a day, try to drink more water also according to your need. And when we are meeting here the same time, same topic with the same region on Monday, we will see good applications in Ayurveda and we'll see good applications in yoga also. Until then, take care of yourself. Stay away from the bad habits. Do yoga also. Thanking you all to giving me this wonderful opportunity.